All we need now is Ryan and Amy. And for you to keep your nose out of our picnic hamper, Patch.
Hi, Stan.
We're here.
Are you ready?
Well, let's see. I've got sandwiches, Pop, Ryan, Amy, Stan, and Little Red Tractor. Yep, I reckon we're all ready for our picnic.
Ah, Stan, there you are.
Hello, Mr. Jones. Hi, Thomas.
Hi, Stan.
I've come to ask you a favour, Stan. See, I've been digging a drainage ditch in one of my fields.
It's really hard work, isn't it, Uncle Jasper?
I'll say, yes, that is no. No, not at all. Piece of cake. Only,
but you said...
Only, I've been called away on business and I was wondering...
If I could finish the ditch off for you.
Thank you, Stan, I knew I could rely on you.
Thing is, we were going on a picnic.
Well, you can have your picnic in my field. Maybe you could take Thomas with you.
A picnic? Yeah.
Well, that's settled then. See you later.
Well, what are we waiting for?
Stan, do you want some of these sandwiches?
Phew, yeah. This digging builds up quite an appetite. Thanks, Amy.
Maybe we could give you a hand.
I don't know. It's very hard work.
I'm pretty strong.
Me too. We can do it.
Right then.
Hang on. I think I found something. It looks like a coin. And there's more down here. Look!
Wow. You know what, Ryan? I think these might be Roman coins.
Roman?
I don't believe it.
Treasure!
Hello, Mr. Jones. We finished your ditch.
What? Yes.
Uncle Jasper, we were digging your ditch. And Ryan found some coins.
They look really
Stan
old.
Stan says they might be Roman.
Yes,
so
I didn't. Quiet! Roman coins on my land. These might be worth something. And I might even get my picture in the papers again. Well done, Ryan. Thank you very much for these.
They're not for you. We found them.
What? I mean, what? But,
I think the best thing would be to take them to the Babel Brook Museum. Have them take a look at the coins and see what they can make of them. Bye, Mr. Jones.
Bye, Thomas.
See you later.
Should have dug that ditch myself.
Perhaps there's more.
That's it, Thomas. Yes. And if we find more coins, I can keep them. All we need is a metal detector. Wow! Powerful! Powerful!
Stumpy, are you all right?
Oh, never better, Stan. Never better.
We're famous.
Are you now? Well, well, well. And how's that then?
I found some Roman coins.
We took them to the museum, and the man there said they were.
Were what?
Roman. And he's going to put them on display in the museum.
They're going to be called the Turvey Collection.
After us.
Well now, isn't that something? Roman coins, eh?
Can't wait to tell Mum and Dad.
Maybe it's about time we were getting back.
Roman coins. Yeah, that reminds me.
Stumpy! Stumpy?
Where is it? I'm sure... No. Hang on it! No. Not there. Oh, where is it?
Stumpy?
I knew I'd seen it!
Seen what?
This!
Yes, but what?
See you later!
Oh, I don't know.
We found just there, Uncle Jasper.
There must be some more coins around here somewhere. Come to Daddy. Come out, wherever you are.
Oh, Stumpy! Nearly scared the life out of me. What on earth possessed you to jump out at me like that? Sorry, Mr. Jones. In a bit of a hurry. See, I bumped into Stan, well, a wall, actually, and he told me he'd found some Roman coins. And I remembered I'd got an old map of me dad's. It marks the spot of a Roman fort. Of course, boundary lines have changed a bit since his day, but I reckon it's somewhere around here.
Perhaps I could have a look.
There, see?
Hang on, Stan.
In a bit of a rush, I want to show it to Stan.
Well, if Stumpy's maps were right,
The fort should be somewhere over there. And when I find it, I'll be on the front page of the Babblebrook Gazette.
Wee, Uncle Jasper. I'm helping, remember?
Yes, yes, of course. Hello? Oh, stupid thing. Hello? No, no, not you, my dear. Is that the Babblebrook Gazette?
Well, like I say, Stan, the boundaries have changed a bit since my old dad was a lad.
But here's Tawny Owl Wood.
And I reckon that must be the Roman fort.
So it looks as if the fort might be in Top Acre. Come on, little red tractor. Let's go and have a look.
Hello! Sounds like I found... a horseshoe!
Oh! Oh, you should be more careful.
This time, yes, I'm sure I found. Sorry I didn't see you there. You're the chap from the Babblebrook Gazette. Have I got a story for you? You've arrived at just the right moment. Think I found something big. Aha. I appear to have detected your stuff.
Yes. Now, Mr. Jones, you say you've unearthed a Roman fort.
Well, almost.
Oh, hot work, this, Stan. Are you sure we're looking in the right place?
According to your dad's map, Stumpy, it ought to be somewhere around... Aha! Look at this. It's a brick.
Great. A brick.
But nothing's been built around here for ages. And look, here's another. I reckon this is part of a wall, Stumpy. And it looks as if it carries on along under there.
Under that tree stump? Well, that's that. We'll never shift it.
I think Little Red Tractor has other ideas.
You haven't found a fort at all, have you, Mr. Jones?
Well, not yet, but I'm sure it's round here somewhere. We saw it on the map, didn't we, Thomas?
I suppose so.
Come on, Little Red Tractor. You can do it.
Nothing doing, Stan!
Come on, one more try.
It's moving! Go on, Little Red Tractor. Keep it going!
Great stuff, Little Red Tractor. I knew you could do it.
Stan, come and take a look at this. Right, Mr. Jones, I've got things to do. I said, Mr. Jones!
I found something! I definitely found something, and this time it's big!
Yes, but... Oh.
Wow. Looks like we found the Roman fort, all right.
Oh, thanks to Little Red Tractor.
Just wait till the people at the Babblebrook Museum see this. Hello. Can you hear that?
Yes. Sounds like a badger. With a beeper.
Ow! Almost got... Yes, it's... what's this? Stupid! Hear me! I seem to have detected Little Red Tractor.
And we found the fort.
Call yourself a metal detector. Why couldn't you have worked faster?
Over here, please. Can I have a picture of the treasure seekers?
Historic find by local man and his tractor. Pretty good stuff, eh?
We're all famous.
Thanks to a bit of help from Little Red Tractor.
You really are the best. Morning, Walter.
Hello, Stan. Hey, aren't you two going the wrong way?
No, we've been out and about. Just popping up to check on the cows before heading home for breakfast.
Right, what can I do for you?
We're fine, thanks. Only stopped by to say hello.
Ah, that's nice. But come on, diesel? A little drop of oil?
Well, seeing as you've got your hose out, you could top up Little Red Tractor's radiator.
Ah, now you're talking.
Right, Big Blue. Let's start building this new duck pond. Easy now. Lovely. One more load should do it. Make it nice and deep for our little ducklings. Mm? There you go. One topped-up tractor.
Thanks, Walter. Now we'd better let you get on. See you.
Yeah, yeah. Catch you later.
Another satisfied customer, Sparky.
Hey,
that's odd.
Niggler, you haven't turned the water off, have you?
Poking with your oar.
That's not nice.
I'll do it then.
Don't, Ryan. Stumpy!
Stumpy!
Oh, my hat! Oh, come on, you two, get your backs into it. We'll never reach the seaside if you don't row.
I don't think we'll get to the seaside at all. There's no water.
No water? Where'd the water go?
It's gone, Stumpy. Dried up.
Oh, okay. Okay, now, you just sit tight and I'll go for help.
Sorry, girls. Didn't know you were out of water. Oh. Now, why isn't that working? I wonder if our neighbour's having water trouble.
Oh, it's no good. I'm stuck fast.
What are we going to do now?
I don't know, Amy, love.
We could try walking for it. We're a lot lighter than Stumpy.
No, don't do it. What if you two sink as well?
Yeah, I guess you're right.
I think I've got an idea.
No water here either. Now, I wonder where Mr. Jones is. Let's try back at the garage. Perhaps Walter's seen him. Hold on. That sounds like Big Blue. They must be in the back field.
Oh, no, why didn't I think of that? Sometimes, Stumpy, I think there's nothing under your hat.
Yeah!
Woohoo!
Well done, kids!
We'll go get some help!
Go and get Mr. Jones, he's closest! And run! I'm still sinking!
Marvellous! Strong as...
Look what you've done!
What? Oh, yes, we've been very busy beavering away, building our dam.
You've blocked the river.
River? It was never much of a river. Besides, I made a lovely duck pond, and it shouldn't be long before the wild ducks fly in. Who could resist such a beautiful little pond?
But you've stopped the water from flowing onto my farm.
Never mind. I'll let you have some of mine. I've got loads.
There's none at your farm either.
What? Oh. Now that won't do.
Stan! Stumpy's stuck!
Sinking in the mud.
The boat got stuck.
The river dried up.
He was getting help.
Whoa! Slow down!
The river dried up.
The boat got stuck in the mud.
Now Stumpy, stuck in the mud.
And he's sinking.
Oh, dear. Come on, you two. Jump in the trailer.
Stan, you may want to hurry the dam. Not as strong as first thought.
Come on, let's go.
Oh, looks like we've fouled things up again.
Yo! Quick, Stan! I'm sinking fast!
Don't worry, Stumpy. We'll get you out of there, won't we, little red tractor? Right, grab hold of the rope when I throw it.
Grab it, Stumpy!
I can't! The more I move, the more I sink!
I'll give it another go.
Oh, this doesn't look good. And I bet if Stumpy gets washed away, it's me who will get the blame. I know. Come on, Big Blue. Let's go and save the day. We will be heroes.
Let's hope this works.
Go on, Stan.
Yeah!
Well, hey! You got me!
Get ready, Stumpy.
Right, I'm ready!
OK, little red tractor. We will have to be really careful here.
Oh, gently, Stan.
That's it, boy. Nice and slow.
Oh, the rope's starting to nip me.
Are you starting to move yet?
No, I'm starting to stretch. Oh.
Well done, little red tractor.
Oh, safe and sound. Oh, no. My boots are gone.
Well, at least you're safe.
It's okay. It's okay. We are here. Right. No time to lose. We'll need a rope and... Stumpy, you don't look like you're in any danger at all.
I was in great danger, but I've been saved.
We all saved him.
Me and Amy had to save ourselves first.
Ah. So there's no one left for me to save them?
Afraid not. You're a bit late.
Yeah, well, what stumped me is why we got stuck in the first place. I mean, where'd the river go?
Mr. Jones, I think you can explain that.
Yes, quite. Well, you see, I was building a pond for the little fluffy ducklings, and, all I did really was block the river.
Block the river? You blocked the river? What sort of daft thing is...
It was for the ducklings. Little duckies?
Our boat's really soaked now.
We'll never get to the seaside.
No, not without a boat.
Mr. Jones, don't you have a boat?
Boat? No, more like a yacht, really. It's got a mast and everything. Ah, I see. I think I've just caught your drift. Look, why don't we all drive down to the seaside and take my yacht out for the afternoon?
It's not the same.
Well, I could come and rescue your little boat later. What do you say?
Yeah, great!
Come on, Stumpy, pull your socks up. Where on earth are your boots?
My boots are at the bottom of that. No thanks to you.
Well, we can stop in at Countryside and Water on our way and pick you up a new pair of boots.
Ah, you're on. I could do with a nice relaxing afternoon sailing after all that excitement. Oh, new boots too. Did you hear that, feet? Oh, thanks, Stan. And thank you too, little red tractor.
It was no problem.
Oh, I'd have been a goner if it weren't for you. You two really are the best.
Wakey, wakey, little red tractor. Rise and shine. Exciting news. Veronica is due to have her calf today, so I thought we'd take a drive out to Top Acre to see how she's doing. No sign of Veronica. No, that's a good sign. Cows often wander away from the herd when they're about to have a calf. Let's have a look up the top end. Shh! Look, there she is. We mustn't disturb her. We'll pop back later and make sure she's okay.
Stan, how are you then?
Shh!
How are you then?
I'm fine. Veronica is about to have a calf. We're trying not to disturb her.
Oh, I see. Well, don't you worry. We won't make a sound.
Thanks, Stumpy. We'll see you later.
Gently now, Nipper. Let's not startle Veronica. Wow! Sorry, ladies.
Mr. Jones! Mr. Jones!
morning, Stan. Going to chop down the old tree here for a bit of firewood.
Can I ask a favour?
Favour? Will it cost me anything?
No, it's just that Veronica is about to have a calf. I was wondering if you could keep the noise down.
Not a problem. I'll be as quick as you like. Right equipment for the job, you see.
Thanks. Bye.
And they said this old car would never run again. But Walter, the expert mechanic, has spoken too soon.
Why? Eh? Why do you keep doing this to me? Have I ever upset you? Have I? Are you mooing at me? Oh, hi, Nicola. Huh? No, I was just... broken down. How did you know? No, the car is making mooing noises. Well, I thought it was strange too. Here, can you come by and give me a tow? Yeah. Thanks, girl. Bye. That's it. It's definitely the scrapyard for you this time. And will you stop doing that?
Hi, Stan.
Hi there. I didn't expect to see you today.
We've come to see if everything's all right with Veronica.
As far as I know.
It's just that we were worried.
Worried? Whatever for?
Well, we passed Topeka and noticed the gate was open and we just...
Open?
Yeah, we thought that maybe there'd been a problem.
There wasn't, but there may be now. Thanks for telling me, but I have to rush. I'll phone you later and let you know the news.
I hope Veronica's okay.
Stan, Little Red Tractor, make sure she is. Don't worry.
Stan didn't finish feeding the pigs.
Come on, we can do it.
Oh, no. Veronica has wandered off to be on her own. She could be anywhere. Come on, let's see if Mr. Jones is still in the next field. Maybe he's seen something. Mr. Jones?
Stan, any news about your calf yet?
No, Veronica's gone missing. Don't suppose you've seen her, have you?
No, been a bit busy. Worked quick, though, like I promised.
Thanks. We'll go back up the other way.
I don't suppose you're interested in buying... a few bits of firewood?
I can't understand it.
They were strange sounds. It's a bit like mooing.
Have you seen Veronica anywhere?
Your cow?
Yes, somehow she got out of Top Acre. She's expecting a calf any time. I'm very worried.
Cow? I'm an idiot. A cow, of course!
Walter?
I thought the car was making mooing noises, but it must have been...
Veronica! Which direction did the sound come from?
Oh, well, you see, I wasn't really listening. I thought it was the car, you see.
Tell you what, Stan, I'll go this way and you check back that way.
Deal.
Well, what about me? What about my car?
The car can wait, and the garage is unmanned. Could you wander back, Dad, and I'll come back for you as soon as we've found Veronica.
Thanks, Nicola. Give me a call on the mobile if you see anything.
Will do.
This is all your fault. Making mooing noises.
What say we check the fields? Come on, Little Red Tractor. Let's go.
Veronica!
Look! They look fresh. I'm sure these belong to Veronica. Come on, Little Red Tractor. We'll follow them. Steady now.
Whoa! Whoa!
Oh. Sorry, Stumpy. I don't suppose you've seen Veronica anywhere, have you?
No. I've been busy fixing Nipper here. We had a bit of a ding with the gate up at Top Acre this morning.
What time?
Oh, I don't know. I just seen Stan and then we bumped into the,
The gate! That's it! That's how she must have got out.
I'm sorry. I didn't think to check the gate. Come on, I'll help you look.
Oh, I'm hearing mooing wherever I go now. Hey, just a minute. That's coming from inside the garage. Oh. Veronica? Veronica, there you are. Now, don't you worry now. Everything's gonna be fine. Oh, Stan's gonna be so relieved.
Whoa!
Walter, it's the strangest thing.
I was just about to call you.
We were following hoof prints, but they stopped just before the garage.
I found Veronica. You won't believe this, but...
You found her.
Yeah, she's round the back, sheltering in the garage. Good as gold.
That is a relief.
Well, what do we do now?
Nothing we can do but wait. You can't hurry Mother Nature.
Shh!
I haven't said anything. I only wanted some diesel.
Shh!
Veronica is in the bay waiting to have her calf.
Yeah, sorry, but we're closed until the little one is born.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
You'll have to wait. I don't think it will be long now.
You can't hurry Mother Nature.
Oh, very well.
Stan, it's all my fault! You see, I...
Shh!
What?
You found her.
Yes, she's in the garage here. About to give birth, I think.
Oh, that's great news. So, what do we do now?
We wait! You can't hurry Mother Nature!
We may as well eat. I'll get some sandwiches.
That sounds promising.
About my diesel.